Amen. Last week, we have learned about the success of Ezra when he traveled from, where's that? Babylon to Jerusalem. And today, we are going to learn about Joshua. Who heard about Joshua? Joshua, not our dear brother here. Joshua. You know what? I envied Joshua. Why? Because he was able to witness the man, I think for me, the greatest or one of the successful leader in the Bible. And his name was Moses. You know what? Moses, in the book of Exodus, you would learn how he led the Israelites going to the promised land. And I would like you to understand today that this young Joshua, he saw this man, Moses, when he was young, maybe at the age of 17, 18. Imagine, oh, Jonas turning 18, he was 17, he's 17 right now. Imagine that man, that young boy, you experienced and you witnessed the power and the ability and the strength of this man, Moses. If you don't know Moses, Moses was one of the great leaders in the Bible. Imagine this Joshua. He was there with Moses when he was young in Egypt. He saw Moses facing the mighty Pharaoh. Imagine yourself, seeing this mighty man of God facing the mighty man Pharaoh, the mighty man of this world. What I'm telling you right here is Moses was a successful man, and he was witnessed by this young man Joshua. And imagine when Moses faced Pharaoh, he led these Israelites out of Egypt. Imagine this. And you, this young man, you saw Moses led the Israelites. And then after that, when you saw Moses divided the Red Sea, how would you feel? And then when these Israelites, they were moaning and grumbling, Moses led us out of Egypt without any food. And then maybe Joshua said, we're dead. He saw with his own eyes. He saw that Moses provided manna from heaven through his prayer. God sent manna from heaven and Moses provided for the Israelites. We don't know how many Israelites during the time on the desert, about 3 million, 4 million, 5 million. How would you provide for these people? And Moses did it. And Joshua saw it. He saw how great Moses was. How great Moses during that time. He saw him. I just would like you to imagine right now. If you're in the shoes, or if you're in the place of Joshua, seeing this power, these miracles, day after day, through Moses, what would you feel? Maybe you ask, what kind of man is this? He divided the Red Sea. He led a million of people in the desert. How would you feel? You would be impressed. You would idolize Moses. Joshua witnessed the life of the greatest leader ever lived. One of the greatest that ever lived, Moses. He saw the pain,
the struggle, and the victory
of Moses. But one day, we'll go to the book of Joshua, chapter 1. God spoke to Joshua, and this is his word. Right here. Everyone. This is the word of God to Joshua. After the death of Moses, the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses, imagine that the one whom he saw during the time of the Egyptian Exodus. They went out of Egypt. He saw the Red Sea divided, and now God told him that Moses is dead. Would you feel if you were in the place of Joshua, your leader, whom you follow, whom you obey, is now dead? Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, then, you, God told Joshua, now, then, you, who, me? Yes, you, Joshua. Joshua might say, who, me? Yes, you, Joshua, I am talking to you. The verse says, you, and not only you, all these people, get ready to cross the Jordan River. Can't imagine the feeling of Joshua during that time. When his beloved leader is dead, how could I face the future now that my leader, my Moses, my beloved leader, powerful leader, is dead? Now God is calling Joshua, and not only calling Joshua, but he's asking Joshua to cross the Jordan River. Imagine yourself. Your leader is dead, and now you are called, and now you're going to pass the Jordan River. We have different Jordan River. We have different situations in life. God called Joshua to cross the Jordan River in the land I am about to give you, the Israelites. But there's a promise of God. We'll continue reading. Please hold on. Stay back there. I will give you every place where you take your food, as I promised Moses. And from the great river, the Euphrates, all to Lebanon, and from the great river, and to Lebanon. Sorry, I have to read here. I'm having a hard time reading this. Your territory will extend from the desert to Lebanon, and from the great river, the Euphrates, all the Hittite country, to the Mediterranean Sea in the west. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, I will be with you, and I will never leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their ancestors to give them. Church, do not claim this particular promise for yourself, because this particular command and promise to lead the Israelites to victory is specifically given to Joshua. You cannot literally cross the Jordan River. Don't fly from New Zealand, go to Jordan River and cross the Jordan for yourself. No, you'll get into trouble. Do not possess the country Lebanon, or you might get into trouble. Do not possess the Euphrates or the Mediterranean Sea in the west, you'll get into trouble. What we would like to learn today from this text and the following four or three verses is not crossing the Jordan River by yourself, literally, or extending your territory to Lebanon or the Mediterranean Sea. That's not what I would like to get today. What we would like to get today is God's principle that He would like us to succeed, that He would like us to succeed in this life that we have, just like He would like to succeed, He would like to see the people of Israel to succeed, and how we are going to succeed in life. You know what? God wants you to succeed. That's given. That's from the Bible. God, He's delighted when His people get prospered and become successful. And that's what going, and that's what's going to learn today, church. We are going to succeed. How? I would like to entitle the message today. Before that, I would like to get this thing. Be strong and be courageous. Maybe this is your word for today. We would like to hold on to this word. Be strong and be courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from the right or to the left, and you, that you may be successful wherever you go. I don't know your situation right now, but you know what? We have different situations in life. We have our own Jericho. We have our own Jordan River to cross. We have our own people to face. We have our own territory to conquer. I don't know your situation, but right now, let me tell you, the way God told Joshua, be strong and be courageous, because you will succeed. God wants you to succeed. I would like to entitle this time today, you will succeed. Tell the person next to you, you will succeed. Yes, you will succeed. I am telling you today, you will succeed. Because that's God's plan. That's God, that's the plan of God for every people. But the verse didn't stop there. We have to follow through. From verse 7, we'll go to verse 8. First, before you succeed, you have to keep the word of God with you. Let's continue reading in verse 8. This is a very popular verse. I know young people, young children, you know, and you memorize this. Maybe God will memorize this word. Keep this book of the law on your lips. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it, then you will be prosperous and successful. You know what? Because I really would like this church to succeed. Every family represented here, every person, every individual, every father, every mom, every son or daughter in this room, I would like to see you succeed in life. 2017, we have just started 2017. And I would like you to give this admonition. Keep the word of God with you. Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Another translation says, do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. You want to be successful. Listen to this. You should always keep the marching order. It is the word of God. And do not let it depart from you. Keep this word of God. Keep this word of God, this marching order with you. All the time, always on your lips. Do not let it depart from you. It doesn't matter if you don't know the details of your future. What course? Who you're going to meet? What at school? What party? What kind of business? What kind of job you're going to take? It doesn't matter if you don't know the details of your future or the next step you're going to take. It doesn't matter. Or even how far you would go, or how you would succeed in life. It doesn't matter if you don't know all the details of those things. What matters most is you have to keep with you always the word of God that will teach you all you need to know about God, about His power, about His grace, about His mercy, about His love that will help you to succeed. That's why I am telling you as your pastor, as your leader, I would like you to always keep the word of God with you. I'm not saying that you should carry your Bible wherever you go. I'm not saying that you should keep your Bible in the toilet. I'm not saying that you should keep your Bible with you in your car, wherever. Oh, that's fine if you could do that. That's okay. What I'm telling you here, keep the word of God on your lips. Assuming keep the word of God in your heart. Because out of the overflow of your heart mouth speaks. Always on your lips, you keep the word of God in your heart. The psalmist said in Psalm 119, I have hidden your word in my heart so that I may not sin against you. Now, do you still want to succeed in life? Then, you have to keep the word of God with you. Not carrying it literally, but put it in your heart so that it would overflow with your lips. It was said that speaking the word with your lips, it helps you to memorize, right? Teachers, were teachers here? For you to memorize something, you have to speak loudly. But you know what? For me, speaking the word of God with my lips also helps me and reminds me about the truth, about God. Have you experienced that? Speaking the word of God with your lips? What does that happen? Speaking the word of God with your lips. What do you mean? Yes. And I hope after this message that you would start speaking the word of God with your lips. You would like to shout it, you would like to speak it with boldness, then speak. Instead of entertaining, saying yourself, I am so weak. Why not say with your mouth, I am strong in Christ. I am teaching you here how to succeed in life. You can read so many books how to succeed in life, but you know what? You only find it in the Bible. In Joshua, his feelings, how to succeed in life. Actually, Moses gave him that man. The law, the book of the law was given to Moses. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, it was given to Moses. And all the Israelites, they were following this. And instead of allowing yourself to self-eat and tell yourself, I am alone, I am alone. There was one lady, Chinese lady, yesterday, came here looking for a church. He told me and my wife, she said, I am lonely because I am alone. Beautiful, you're not alone. That was with you. And her countenance suddenly changed. See how powerful the word of God when you use it, when you speak it. When you use it to encourage people. Instead of telling yourself, I am poor, I am weak, why not confess with your mouth that I am strong in Christ, that I am victorious, that I am rich in Christ, that Christ is my provider. Instead of walking around there saying that I am a loser. Why not tell yourself, I am a winner? Come on, speak to yourself. Face the mirror every day. Tell the mirror, you can do it, June. I called you. I have chosen you. You are my servant. God is telling you. Come on, speak the word. Face the mirror. You know, you would see. You would see the result. You would see the result. You have to season all your conversations with your friends, with your classmates, with the word of God. Because when you season your conversation with the word of God, lies, negativities, doubts, fear, gossip, meaningless talk that hinders you to success, those things will be eliminated. There will be no room for meaningless talk. You're going to season your word with your lips, your conversation with the word of God. So you have to keep the word of God with you. You know how the word of God with you? Memorize. Read the word of God. Bring it with you. Everywhere you go. Hide it in your heart. And that's how you will succeed in life. Is it difficult to bring the word of God with you? I know you are so afraid or you're ashamed to bring Bible, big Bible with you on your armpit, walking around. If you're afraid to do that, just hide it inside your heart. So that when problems, when difficulties, when trials come, you have the Word of God in you to fight. And as we continue reading on this verse, same verse, it says there, what's the next? Meditate on it day and night. First is you have to keep the Word of God in you. And then, next is you have to meditate on it day and night. Meditate the Word of God. You would like to succeed in this life, you have to meditate the Word of God. This is the Word of God, this is not the Word of Jude. Actually, you can read it by yourself, but you know what? There is power in meditating on it day and night. Most of us read the Bible casually and carelessly. Who could say amen? Most of us read the Bible carelessly and casually. It has no effect. No, I'm giving you advice, church, on how to succeed and how to grow in life. This is a simple principle in the Bible telling us how to succeed. It has no effect on us if we are going to just read it casually and carelessly. I must tell you right now, church, that we have to read and understand the Bible, the Word of God, which is the marching order of God for you, for all of us here as a church, as a family. We have to understand it. Don't rush it. Meditate means to give a serious thought. Meditation requires personal investment of time and energy. Again, do you still want to succeed in life? I'll just wait for my fortune. No, you have to meditate on the Word of God if you want to succeed. Listen to God carefully. Shut down or shut yourself from social media when you wake up in the morning. Shut yourself from TV, internet, anything that can distract you. That's the time you can meditate and focus on the Word. Let it speak to your heart. Isn't that great? That the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Creator of heaven and earth, who owns everything, wants to speak to you and give you the keys to success. You cannot meditate the Word of God and your mind is already directed to your breakfast, to your job, to your schools, to your meeting, to your park, to your shopping if you're going to do after that. But you have to focus on the Word of God if you would like to meditate. Can I give you a tip? Do you know how to do a devotion in the morning? A very person that doesn't know how to do a devotion. Simple, church. When you wake up in the morning, this is what you're going to do. Young people, mom, dad, this is what you're going to do. Simple. You wake up in the morning, kneel down, pray to God, Lord, this is what I do. Very practical one. Lord, I'm going to open the Bible or my iPad and read your Word. Help me to understand your Word. Then open the Bible. If you have your Bible with you, the Bible, the hard copies, or you have your tablet, go and find a book. And then when you read the book, when you read the Bible, maybe in John, Matthew, or Luke, then read it. Don't rush it. Read it very carefully and look for something that will benefit your soul. Then, Lord, you are saying this to me, and I would like to apply it in my life. Then, after reading it, thank God, Lord, thank you for speaking into my soul. And now I'm ready to go out and live my life using what I've learned. Church, do not stop reading the Word of God or the Bible without getting something. Do not go out without getting something from the Word of God. So easy, right? That's how you do it. You would like to write it down, note it down, then do it. So that's how you do it, simple. You don't have to be a Bible scholar, Bible school student in order for you to have a devotion. You just have to learn it. To reading, understanding the Word of God. You might say, I am very busy, Pastor Jim. How can I have my devotion? How can I meditate in the Word? Who's busy here? Do not be a preacher. I'm busy. Me too, busy. You know, I know you're all busy. I know you're all busy. We have all the reason to say that we cannot have our devotion because we are too busy. Joshua, a very busy person. Imagine, he would cross the Jordan River. He was going to conquer Canaan. He was going to conquer all these Jebusites, Amalekites, all these people. Decided on that land, he would conquer it, and facing all the problems of all the people, millions of people on the place, how could he manage that? But still, he managed to meditate on the Word of God. He even said to the Israelites, you have to keep this book of the law in your heart. During the farewell speech of Joshua. You are busy, then you need meditation. Yes, I am telling you, if you are busy, you need to meditate on the Word of God. Because the Word of God will help you to calm down, will help you to be still and know that you are not God, that God is God and you are just human, who gets tired, who commits mistake, who needs God. Yes, if you are busy, then at the time you should dive into the Word of God and ask God to help you to go through your day, to help you to lead your life, to lead your family, to help communicate with other people. If you are busy, I am challenging you right now, make time on meditating the Word of God. This is the Word of God to you today. Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night. So that you may be careful to do everything written in it. How can you do something without knowing the Word of God? Or doing, how could you do the right thing about God's purpose, about God's will, if you're not meditating the Word of God. So you have to do this third point that I'm going to give you. I don't think you are always hear this third point that I'm going to share with you. You might say, oh, Pastor John, I heard that from your previous preaching last Sunday. You have mentioned that also. But I will continue and I will keep on repeating this point because this is a very important thing. You will succeed if you will what? Obey the Word of God. Again, Pastor June. Yes, in our live groups, I mentioned this. Obey the Word of God because this is the key. I don't care if you meditate on the Word of God, but if you don't obey it, what's good about it? I don't care if you carry your word, the Word of God with you everywhere in your heart. If you won't obey it, nothing would happen. There is no point if you will not obey the Word of God. Obeying the Word of God is very important for us to succeed. It's exemplified in the life. Farewell speech. He says something like this. Be strong. This time Joshua is speaking. The word of God, the one that we have heard a while ago, that was the word of God to Joshua. This time, this is the word of God to Joshua, to the people of Israelites, to Israel. Be strong. Be careful to obey all that is written in the book of the law of Moses without turning aside to the right or to the left. He just repeated it because he experienced that obeying the word of God made him successful. That's why he just repeated it during his last word. It was the last word of Moses, and God told to Joshua, do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth and meditate on it day and night. And Joshua himself, he repeated it because he proved it by himself that obeying God will bring success. And I would like also to repeat it to you today. Do not let this book of the law always depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night. Be careful to do everything written in it. Joshua proved it. And I proved it as well. The blessing comes not from just reading or hearing the word of God, church. I've been repeating this word. The blessing comes from obeying, not just hearing. Our victories will very much depend upon our obedience to God in our whole heart. The question today, do you really obey God? Do you really obey God? I would like to become a successful father, mother, child, engineer, boss, employer. But to no avail, Pastor June. I've been obeying God. To no avail. Ask yourself, do you really obey God? Let's read it. So that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Now, do you really obey God? Let's repeat it again. So that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Now, I would like to ask you again, do you really obey God? So that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Now, I would like to ask you again, do you really obey God? Or you only want to obey God's word on the areas that you feel like obeying God? Many of us would answer yes. Go to church. Yes, check. I go to church every Sunday, Pastor Joel. Present. Read the Bible. Yes, present. I'm reading the Bible every day and every night. Okay, that's all right. Sir, I am serving. I am at a marshal. I am a tech. I'm worshiping here. I serve God. Check, please. Pray. Yes, I pray. I pray in the morning. I pray in the evening, lunch. I pray. That's fine. I obey God. See, I obey God. How about humble yourself? Does it say in the Bible, Pastor Joel? Humble yourself. How about love those people who hate you? Now, do you really obey God carefully? And you careful to do everything written in it? Do you love your boss? Do you love your workmates? Do you love your mean classmates? Do you give your tithe? Ouch. Do you forgive? Do you ask for forgiveness? Do you wait? No. Do you really obey God? It's really hard to say that you obey God. food, to make God everything. Partial obedience is disobedience. Sorry to tell that. Oh, Pastor, I must obey God when I'm ready. When I got money, when I got the job, when I got a stable family, I'm stable. You see, I will obey God. You know what? Let me tell you this. The late obedience is also disobedience. Many say that Christianity is all about commands and all we have to do is to obey, obey, obey. I don't want to go to church because God is always asking me to obey, to obey, to obey. Sounds so boring, boring. Young people, is it boring to hear all these commands and need to obey? But the Word of God is given to us not to make our lives boring. I am telling you this right now. If you think that the Word of God is boring, let me tell you this. Word of God will give to us by God to make our lives boring or miserable or to deprive us. It was given to us to guide us. It is written in Deuteronomy chapter 6, fear the Lord your God as long as you live by keeping all His decrees and commands that I give you so that you may enjoy long life. Isn't that great? The Word of God, the commands of God, given to us for us to enjoy long life, not for us to experience boredom. And it continued, hear Israel, be careful to obey so that it may go well with you and so that you may increase greatly in a land flowing with milk and honey. So keeping the Word of God is not boring. Keeping the Word of God is not depriving us. Giving the Word of God is not what He is to give us an enjoyable long life. Lastly, then we will succeed. Keep His book of the law always in your lips, meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be successful. You will be prosperous and successful. You can ask Abraham. Abraham just obeyed God. And when he obeyed God, he became the father of nations. You can ask David. When David obeyed God, he became a successful king and he became a person after God's own heart. You can ask Jonah. Who is Jonah? Ask Jonah. When he disobeyed God, he was disciplined by God. He was swallowed by a big fish. Ask him again. When he obeyed God, he became a successful missionary. See how obedience brings blessing and success in our lives. I would like to end here. Peter is a veteran fisherman. He's broke. But he was unsuccessful on one of his mission trips. Fishing trip. Overnight, they went fishing. But Peter, the pro, veteran fisherman, was unsuccessful. The whole night, they fished. Nothing happened. Then, he was setting his net, he's about to go home, take breakfast, and rest with his fishermen. And all of a sudden, Jesus Christ said to them, come on, get your net and cast it to this place, to this area. Right? It's not the word God. But if you would think, Peter and Andrew, John, they were veteran fishermen. They listened to Jesus Christ. They fished all night and nothing happened. Just by the look of the sea, they know that nothing could happen. No fish out there. Just by the look of the sun or the wind, they knew right away that there's no fish around. They were pro, they were veterans. They knew what they're doing. When Jesus Jesus Christ said to them, cast your net. Yeah. They casted their net. And they had a big catch. They obeyed. It seems impossible. Right? They just heard word of God, they followed, they obeyed, and they trusted God. You think everything is like Peter? I know how to live my life. I know how to lead my family. I know how to live, how to do things in my workplace. I know how to run my business. But I'm telling you, you don't know everything. You may say you know everything right now, but success only comes from obeying the word of God and trusting God for the consequences of your obedience. You may know everything right now. There are many people out here, and there are many people out there who knew. They know everything. They know a lot. But still, they aren't successful. This word of God taught us today that we have to be strong. Three times, Jesus, God said, be strong and be courageous. Three times, in prayer from verses 1 to 9, three times, He mentioned this word, be strong and be courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go, because I am going to make you suffer. Meditate my words and do everything written in it. Meditate on the word of God. Obey the word of God. Then trust God for the result. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not with your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him and He will direct your path. How can you go wrong? How can you be successful if God's the one leading you, if God's the one directing your path? The only thing that He said, do not lean in your own understanding. Trust me, God is telling you right now. How could I trust you, God? By reading my word. Because by reading my word, you're saying me that you cannot do it by yourself. You are depending on me. That's what God's telling you right now. You don't know everything, my son, my daughter, right now. You need my instruction. You need my marching orders. You need to listen to me. You need to meditate my word, and you have to obey it no matter what. Yes, it seems impossible, and so it's so hard to do. It's not the right thing in the way I look at it, God. But when you say it, I am going to follow and obey you, and success will follow. Yes. You will succeed in this church. You will succeed in your family. You will succeed in your workplace. You will succeed in your business. If you are going to keep the word of God with you everywhere you go, because it is hidden in your heart, then meditate the word of God, not just rushing it, but you have to meditate it day and night. Obey the word of God, church. Obey the word of God. It is a very simple message, actually, but it's so difficult to apply. You're asking my Lord, why I'm not having success in life? My son, I want to see you succeed in this life, my son, my daughter. That's the promise of God. That's the business of God, seeing you succeed in this life. For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and to harm you, prosperity, success. Those are gifts from God. Sometimes we're missing it because we are neglecting the word of God in our lives. And we all stand, church. Father, thank you so much for this word. Thank you for reminding us, Lord, that you would like us to succeed in this life. Church, Fight for your families. Fight for your husband. Fight for your wife. Fight for your children. Fight for yourself. Fight for the people around you. They need to succeed in life. They need success in life. How you can fight for your family, for your children? You have to read the Word of God. Your families, your friends, the church, they deserve success because it is the plan of God. You have to fight for it. You have to fight. You have to look for the Word of God, for His people, for our loved ones, and meditate and apply it, that people around us, our families, can also experience success in life. Father, thank you so much, Lord. We want to obey you in everything, Lord. Not just in the areas that we would like or we feel like obeying. Even though, Lord, it's hard, stop. Sometimes it would hurt us, it would hurt people. God, if it is your word, we would like to obey it, oh God, because it is your ordinance, it is your precepts, it is your command, it is your word. Father, thank you. You're here in this room right now. You are losing hope. There is hope in Christ. There is hope in God. You would like to give up. You would like to surrender in this life because of tough things happening in your life. Come on. Keep the Word of God in your heart. Meditate on the Word of God. Obey the Word of God, experience success. Let us speak to you right now. My son, my daughter, spend time to me. Spend time more. Give more of your time to me, my son, my daughter. I missed you. I'd like to have more time with you. I am the source of everything. Do not rely on the things of this world. Do not rely on your own strength. You need me, my son. You need me, my daughter. Come to me, and I'll give you rest. I'll give you hope. I'll give you future. Because that's my plan. That's who I am. That's my plan for you. God, thank you so much. God, we love you. In Jesus' name, amen, 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 amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.